Hi, this is Steve Matley. I'm here today with Chris York. Chris is a model, an actor, a great guy. He's a generous person. He actually took it upon himself to come from out of state at his own expense to help us with a charity fashion show a few months back for the Inland Valley Business and Community Foundation. We greatly appreciate that. Chris, good to have you here. How are you today?
I'm doing great, Steve. How are you doing?
Good. I wanted to let the audience get to know you a little bit and who you are. I understand you're a former Marine. Tell us a little bit about that background.
I was an engineer in the Marine Corps. I got to go over with a great group of guys and blow up a lot of stuff. And so it was every kid's dream, you know.
That is every kid's dream. You know, when I was in high school, they never showed us that on career day that you could blow things up for a living. I'd have signed up.
You know, it was a blessing. Being an engineer, you get to do a lot of different, you wear a lot of different hats. You know, we worked on generators and water purification units and air conditioning units. And when the right situation came down the pipeline for us to go blow up some stuff up, you know, we probably used a lot more C4 than we should have.
Now, you left the Marine Corps, and I believe you are a student at the University of Utah. Is that correct?
I was so excited to join the military and hesitant at the same, or not, excuse me, not the military, join college. You know, because you in military, you have the GI Bill, and you have all those wonderful benefits that are allotted to you. And I was kind of hesitant to go back to school because I kind of felt this storm coming that I have this dream, and that's why I got out of the military, was to follow this dream. And unfortunately, I did have to drop out.
And this dream would allude to acting modeling,
yes, yep,
performing arts,
modeling, and getting to do those types of things.
So tell me the three best things you've done in acting and modeling so far.
I actually just lucked out unbelievably. My first audition I got, and I got to film a role, getting to play a crazy ex-boyfriend, okay. Which, you know, at one point in my life may have been true, but luckily we're through those days. And that was pretty cool. I got to film that up in Utah, Snow Basin. Okay. That was with Adam Green on the set of Frozen, was a Sundance film, and then was picked up and distributed and shown on the West Coast. There's some wolves and some things that aren't necessary.
So as the crazy ex-boyfriend, were you the topic of the thriller?
I wasn't. The fact that there was wolves and they had to battle all these other elements, okay. And I get to come in and kind of help develop the main characters and their situation together. So I kind of bring them closer because I get to rough up the main character and yell at him because he's looking at my chick all wrong. And it was a good experience.
Great. And then what's the second?
You know what? I actually had an opportunity the last couple of months to work with Wrangler Jeans, okay. Something that I had always wanted to do, represent them being a Southern guy growing up in the military out there. You know, Wranglers is a huge part of, you know, just being Southern and wearing work clothes and riding cows.
You wear Brett Favre's jeans.
You know what? I'm trying everything I can to get in a commercial with him. You know, being a football player my whole life and of course, idolizing Brett Favre and knowing that he's represented by Wrangler. And that would be a cool job to get and just play catch with him.
Okay. So now, you know, if you're able to do that and be part of that, do you become part of the gene pool? Is that what?
You know what, that hopefully that would be a fun process, being part of something like that.
Great. And then what's the third great opportunity you've had?
Browning. I got to do a Browning catalog cover a couple months back, and so being an avid hunter myself, being on the cover of their catalog was a pretty cool accolade.
Were you just in fatigue hunting outfit?
You know, I wasn't on the cover. I was in jeans and had a huge belt buckle and got to nestle up next to a pretty lady, which was pretty cool.
What's your newest project?
You know, I got a couple different projects in the works. I had a gentleman approach me a couple of months, probably about a month ago, to do a role as a Marine. Which is something that
would be quite a stretch for you.
You know,
right?
it'll be a stretch, and I don't know if I'm going to be able to do that. It's going to be a tough character to get into, but I think we'll find him somewhere in there. And something I'm kind of crossing my fingers for is a country boy role. And we had the audition, we had an amazing callback, but I haven't heard the final say so just yet. Sometimes it takes a little longer than others, but I feel really good about it. And I'd get to play a Sundance Kid in a Butch Cassidy and Sundance Kid
film. Oh, that's great.
So it would be a good role.
You have a heart for giving back. You have a heart for generosity and helping people. What drives that? What's the motivating force behind you?
You know, I've been to some crazy places in this world, being in the military, and I've seen some of the worst places that you could ever imagine. And I believe that the United States of America is the best place, you know, in our globe. We have so many beautiful opportunities and just day-to-day life. Even walking out this front door, you know, the door of this building, is a blessing, and to breathe the wonderful air that we have, and just all these different things that people might take for granted. And I want to give back to America, and I want to make American soil, you know, what it used to be. You know, speaking of after, you know, any career that I might have, I'd like to start my own charity one day and just try to give back and make this country, you know, great and what it is.
You've done some small things to help us and some big things to help us. I want people to know Chris went out of his way to really help with our charity organization, not even knowing us. He reached out to us and was a big part of our community event, and we so much appreciate that. I understand you did a little bit of cover magazine signing today. How did that go?
It went great. You know, a lot of people, we didn't have a lot of time to kind of pump out the event and get right. it, you know, tell people that we were going to be out here. But, you know, the people that did show up, it was awesome for them to come out, and I got to sign my first autograph.
Good.
You know, and it's all great to come out here and get to see you guys again and build more awareness towards, you know, the long-term goal, which is to help people and be a good, positive enforcement in this community and in my community, and hopefully one day to make this big enough to where we can start branching out and helping people in other communities and just try to spread the message that, you know, that we're homelessness and abuse, you know, SAFE, which is the other project that you guys work with, SAFE Alternatives, is something that we all can stand behind and help build more awareness and help as many people as we can, so which is the ultimate goal.
Chris has been a great part of helping our organization, and we wish him all the best in everything he does. Again, Chris York, he's an actor, he's a model, and as you now know, an all-around really great guy. So thank you, Chris, for being with us today.
Yes,
do you have any final parting words?
You know, just God bless America, God bless this land of freedom and the opportunities that it affords me every day, and thanks for having me on the show.
Amen to that. This is Steve Matley. Thank you for joining us, and thank you for watching our interview with Chris York. And by all means, go on YouTube, get the lifestyle magazine he's in, and support what he's doing. You'll find that he is an extremely talented and generous young man.